As I said, the Monte Carlo is very important to decide if the strategy is worthy testing it on a demo or a live account. And it performs such simulations that are nearly impossible to be done manually. So I will start with the first one, randomized history data. And as you can understand from the name, it will mix a little bit the history data, or it will create some noise. So we can see if the strategy is doing well, if the historical data was slightly different, right? And you can see that the backtests are quite similar, not really a huge difference. And it will perform a certain number of tests before ending the progress. And you can change all of these from the options, but let me wait just a little bit more. By default, we have 20 tests. We can see that the results are all right. And if I hit on options, you can lower that number. For example, you can select to do just 10 tests or more, but I will stick to the default in here. Now, if we select to test the strategy with randomized spread, it will perform back tests with different spread from the one we have set in the historical data. And by default, it will check with a range from 10 to 30 points. Okay, so let me run such a test and we will see if this strategy will perform worse if the spread is bigger. And that's quite important for many strategies. Many strategies will fail in this test, and especially the scalping strategies, those that are for M1 and M5, they are quite dependent on the spread. And I try to stay away from such strategies, to be honest with you. And once the calculation is over, you can see that we have the very same results. Then we have execution problems. You can test how the strategy will perform if your broker does randomize slippage, or if it will randomly close the position or skip the positions exits. Now, I don't have such an issues with my broker because I tested it. However, if you're doing it for the first time, I would strongly suggest you to check with a few strategies. But if you find out that your broker skip positions, exits and entries, or there is huge slippage, then you definitely need to look for a different broker. The strategy variations are important as well. We can test the strategy with randomized indicator parameters, which means that the Monte Carlo will backtest the strategy with, for example, Kettler channel, not 195 but 200, or 185, 170, 160, different combinations to see if that strategy will become losing. And that's a good test to see if the strategy is over optimized. And for the beginners, over optimized means that the strategy was generated ideally for the backtesting period, and the generator found such a combination between indicators and parameters that will show just a nice backtest. And if we change any of the indicator parameters, we will see a losing strategy. And we want to stay away from over optimization, okay? And on the right side, we have the confidence table, where I'm not going again into details, but what I can see in the test charts is that just one or two tests went on negative and most of the others were positive, right? And the last one is randomized backtest starting bar, or in other words, Monte Carlo will see if the starting bar was crucially important for the backtest or not, and it will simulate a few tests starting from a later or earlier period. Here we can see that it is just fine. So the ones that I use the most are the randomized spread and the randomized indicator parameters, okay? These two, I wanna see if the strategy will pass at least 15 out of the 20 or 16 out of the 20, which is like 80% of the test. If it passes like 80% of the tests, I am confident to use that strategy, and I'm not worried that the strategy was over-optimized. And to explain the over-optimization, I will show you a few manual tricks. Okay, here are the results. Just one went on zero, which is okay out of 20 tests. Now let me go back to the editor for this strategy, and I said that I will show you a few manual tricks to explain what actually the Monte Carlo does. If I change the EBA period to 194, we can see that there was a change, but not a drastic change. It's still a positive strategy, right? If I increase it to 196, pretty much the same thing, even it's getting a little bit better. No, actually with 195 is better. Same thing with the gutter oscillator. I can increase the jaws period. Let's see. Okay, here we have a little bit different equity chart, but still a profitable one. And if I continue increasing, you will see that the recent period gets worse. So by changing manually, I see if this strategy was over optimized. If I want to do it quicker, then Monte Carlo is a pretty good solution that I'm always using. So once you like a strategy, you should go through the Monte Carlo and see if this strategy is robust or not. The other thing you can do is to reduce the maximum position amount. Let's reduce to 0.30. You see it's getting worse. 0.20, I guess it will be even lower result. Yep, let's increase it to 0.5. Oh, that's horrible for the strategy. I get a margin call at one moment. So 0.4 is okay. That's where we want to go. Okay guys, so this is how I filter the strategies, and in the next video I will select one more strategy from this collection to put on my MetaTrader for trading. And for now I will save this strategy as EURUSD M15, let's say first strategy, okay? And I will create a portfolio of strategies from different assets, so I will diversify the risk, and I will show you how I do that in the next videos.